winning a supercross race was always my childhood dream.
Jessy Nelson comes to Anaheim.
I just do it because I like it. I remember being that kid. It was so cool to meet somebody you watched on TV.
Fast forward to Anaheim 1.
Just watching him do laps, I was like, this guy's gonna win.
Contact in the first corner, but everybody stays upright.
Probably one of the coolest things watching him race that race. He was just in his zone. And
to win the opening, Anaheim was amazing. I was screaming. I get excited easy. It was worth all the late nights, and it was a dream come true. Give me chills right now just remembering it.
That dream became reality, and from there it became championships.
Well, Jessy Nelson is excited to be up here.
I wasn't done racing for me, so this is another way for me to fulfill something, and I'm not done yet, that's for sure. To tell stories of silver linings is one thing, to live it is another.
Riding the number 3 KTM here at the Fresno Fairgrounds is Jessy Nelson out of Templeton. We always look for Jessy to be out in front, as he has been dominating this class for quite some time now.
Jessy Nelson!
Well, Jessy Nelson is excited to be up here.
Jessy, full body Nelson. You guys look for this kid coming up. He's obviously got the speed, he's got the battle, he's got the heart.
Man, it's awesome to see American Suzuki taking a chance at signing Jessy Nelson, a kid from Central California. He's just 11 years old.
And you're obviously one of the top riders this week. You've opened up a lot of eyes. A lot of guys are saying, who is this guy? Who, as far as speed-wise, and you definitely showed him a lot of heart yesterday.
The 85 starts 10-11. He's got a stranglehold on the competition. The 46th of Jessy the Body Nelson.
I've never raced before. It's his dream, and he's taken it to a level that's unbelievable, actually, and we're just going to follow him.
Factory Honda has liked what it's seen with Jessy Nelson, and they have inked him to a brand-new contract.
Was on Team American Suzuki. That was good. And then I signed with American Honda and then started riding their bikes, and I liked them a lot. I just had a little bad luck.
I wasn't there. First time I really wasn't there. I was hurt myself. We had a rough go. Our whole family had a rough go. We had a lot of things happening, and I sided on a berm or something and got his thumb caught in the sprocket or chain. I really don't know. But he ended up losing his thumb.
Cut my thumb off.
Me and Mom were like, oh, well, this one's over. We'll find something else to do. How the heck can you ride a motorcycle without a thumb? And he said, I'm not quitting. I'm not gonna be denied what I wanna do. And 3 or 4 weekends later, he was racing at a local race. He'd been winning again, he just seemed to have more desire and heart to win. And the motorcycle landed and broke his femur.
Broke my femur.
Took him to the hospital there too, and it was like, we're so done. This is getting old. And he says, I'm not quitting. He goes, I am not quitting.
Now that I'm fully healthy and ready to race, so I think I'm going to do pretty good this year.
The 479 of Jessy Nelson is back, and he's faster than ever. To me, when I watch Jessy Nelson out there, I see a humble kid, a kid who doesn't have a lot of hype around him, and technically he's one of the better riders out there on the track. He's able to put the bike wherever he wants to, and he's certainly future is bright.
Somebody to have that kind of passion for the sport, and there's a lot of them out there. If anybody watches motocross or supercross, there's a lot of people that have that passion, but there's a few that really have the heart and drive, I guess, to try to go all the way or go all the way. I'm serious. I don't know, he's been through some rough stuff, and I'm telling you to just say, I'm not quitting. No way, I'm not quitting. It's just crazy. There's a lot of top riders. He's just got that heart and desire. He wants to win at all costs, It's in his, I don't know what it is. He's a motocrosser. I don't know. This comes rare, having somebody who's just, I guess, built to be a motocrosser. He just loves it and can't make him stop.
We had the idea of picking up an amateur kid. Jessy Nelson was definitely on our radar. His speed and what he's come through in the past few years is remarkable. So we kind of came to the agreement that Jessy would be a good pick for us.
When I was younger, I'd go rack up 15 to 25 titles a year. If my mind is focused, I seriously think I'm the guy to beat.
Oh, how would I explain to him? Can I cuss?
It's so hard to describe, Jessy.
Dude, there's a lot of different answers for that one.
He's the kid who I talk to probably two, three times a day.
You call him like this little shit, this badass kid on a motorcycle.
Beyond inspiring.
Always a great guy to hang out with and always gives 100%.
It rubs off on everybody. It radiates, and I think people like that.
Outgoing kid.
Dumbass.
Honestly, just a great human being.
Jessy Nelson, to me, like, he's just this rad, talented kid that I got a chance to work on his dirt bikes for a few years and ended up being a really good friend.
He's an American badass.
I remember going to the practice track every day and he was just destroying our guys and just watching him do laps, I was like, this guy's gonna win.
Fast forward to Anaheim 1.
We did press day and I remember he did a couple laps on the track and he came back and he just looked at me and he was like, dude, I'm gonna fucking win tomorrow night, and just gave me a fist pump and I was like, that's badass. And then sure as shit, he went out the next night and did it.
Contact in the first corner, but everybody stays upright. It's Nelson who comes up.
Probably one of the coolest things watching him race that race. He was just in his own and did everything right.
That's Nelson, man. Right out front, dominating the main event.
He's had a great run, Nelson.
I always like to know what he's going, what he's thinking right now. You know, probably this lap probably feels so long to him. I mean, never being on the podium to your first podium appearance, a win.
I think we have pictures of him going across the finish line. He's looking in the tower, I'm screaming at him, and it was more like your little brother just won. You know, it's just like the coolest feeling for me.
Jessy Nelson comes to Anaheim, the season opener for the 250 West Championship, and racks up career victory number one.
To win the opening, you know, Anaheim was amazing. I was screaming. I get excited easy. It was worth all the late nights, and you know, it was a dream come true. Give me chills right now just remembering it.
Jessy Nelson is excited to be up here. Your first podium, your first win, and last year you were seventh in points. So what adjustments did you make in the off season to be standing here with me right now?
I think just coming in healthy and being able to put in some solid months of training and. Last year I came in a little injured, so I kind of played a factor in my season, but this year's healthy, strong.
Short of dying, I don't think so. And I hate to even think of that. I, you know, there's so many, you know, you hear about it in motocross because that's the sport we're in, you know, but if we were in football, I'm sure we'd hear about all the injuries and the horrible deaths and stuff like that that happen in football or any other sport. But, you know, he's a smart kid, he rides smart, he's not crazy. You know, there's always a chance, but you know, I'm not going to take the dream away from him. There's no way. I think he would rather, honestly, don't even want to talk about it, but, you know, rather die doing what he wants to do rather than take a chance of, you know, we've talked about this a lot. You know, we could quit motocross. We can go out snowboarding, right? We take him away from motocross, go out snowboarding, and all of a sudden he has a freak accident snowboarding and he breaks his neck or something, and, you know, then what have we done? You know, why don't we just let them do what they want to do and just do the best we can for them, get them all the right stuff and back them the right way.
It just started off as a kind of a rough deal. We actually ended up flying in a day early just because it's a far race. And that night, one of the KTM rig right next to ours completely burned down. And the whole weekend was already just feeling a little weird to me. The track was ridiculous, to be honest. Like, I mean, I like it when it's gnarly because it can definitely separate and like I can start standing up and like riding outside lines or just kind of pick your way through people a little bit easier. And this one was just sketchy everywhere. Like sometimes you come through sections to go hit a step up or even just like a short roller section. Every lap is like, fuck, like I don't even know if I'm gonna make it through this one.
I was standing on the hill. I watched him jump the back jump, like the step up and go into the back section. Then he goes out of my view.
As I was coming down in this left-hander, it's a little bit off camber, and my front end was pointed towards this rut, and then somehow I clipped the side of this track marker. Usually when you hit them, they're pretty soft and flimsy, and they just kind of fall over, this big yellow like track markers. For some reason, they had wood stakes in the back of them, and when I hit it, it was just like a wall, and it just threw me straight off my bike and hit the ground.
I'm kind of waiting. I said, Jesse goes down on the headset.
I started talking about a red flag, and we were like, fuck, like, how bad is it?
I guess my bike must have just hit me in the back, or maybe just, you know, the perfect storm, I guess, with the way I crashed.
His head was facing down the track, and he wasn't moving. Once I got to him, Doc Bodner was yelling, Jesse, Jesse, Jesse. And I ran over and got on my knees and like got right by him, and his helmet was still on.
I was like, is he awake? And he was like, yeah, he's awake. And then you just, fuck, man.
Tough day for sure.
I remember like going to get up, and I was like, oh shit, like, I can't get up. And it was right away, I was freaking out, and then I like feel my stomach and my chest, and like I could feel my ribs but with my hands, but it was like everything was numb and like weird feeling, and I feel my legs and I'm like, oh shit.
I said, buddy, you good? And he kind of rolled his head over and lifted his arms and grabbed my hand and just told me, he said, I'm done. I said, what do you mean? And he had blood coming from his mouth.
TK was like, he said he can't feel his legs. I'm just kind of like,
I was supposed to get life flighted out, and then somehow there was a freak storm rolled in.
Mercy Air or Life Flight wouldn't land because of the storm. We waited probably 5 minutes to wait to see if the storm was gonna change.
Couldn't get life flighted, ended up going to some podunk town.
It was weird, like he might be paralyzed, and it was pouring down rain.
On the way there, I asked the driver of the ambulance, I was like, hey, you got a cell phone? I was like, Mom, I need you to get on a plane right now to New York. She's like, why, what's going on? Freaking out, and I'm like, I'm fucked. Like, end of story, right now I'm fucked. She's like, no, you'll be fine, everything will be okay. Like, just don't even worry about it. And I'm like, I'm telling you right now, like, this is not a good situation. And I was like, you need to get on a plane. And I was like, I want Emily on it with you.
I was on the phone calling to all these different airlines, trying to find a straight shot out there. There was no shot, so we had literally take like 3 flights just to get out there.
Get to the hospital and still not knowing what the hell's going on.
And the doctor came in and said he's got some news for us. They told us that he broke his back and stretched his spinal cord, and they wanted to wait to do surgery.
I've had a lot of friends hurt over the years, you know, but Jesse being so close, it was like this, you know, devastating. And then that's when I started asking myself, what am I doing, man? Why do I have a race team? You start second guessing yourself, and it's, can we make helmets safer? Can we make back protectors safer? What could we have done? How, you know, just run, you know, you run it through your mind 100 times.
The smallest bit of hope, that's all I needed. And nobody was really giving it to me, especially the doctor that I had there. He was a total dipshit, to be honest. Ask him like, hey, what's my shot here? Like, do I have any hope? Should I focus on this? Like, what should I do? Grind out therapy? Should I try to look into stem cells? Should I try to get on some studies right now? Like, what should I do? I'm asking the neurologist there, so-called neurologist, I really don't know. He just replies, I remember it, I get used to that chair. And I was like, fuck you.
It was the first time I broke down when I got on the plane last time. I remember like boarding the plane, and I just broke down like a little bitch.
Fucking started breaking down. I was just like, I'm done. Like, this is it. I almost wasn't even thinking about walking again. It was the fact that I never got to really show my true potential. Like, I could do it out at the test track. I could go do it out at the practice tracks, and I could throw down any given day, and I'd be the fastest one there, or close to it. I just like kept thinking, I was like, no Supercross championship, no more wins, like, no, nothing. Like, what am I gonna do? And it was just like, so much stuff just overwhelming me at one point. I'm sitting here at rock bottom, like, I've got Emily here, I've got my parents, and the team, TK was there, my mechanic, Mario from Red Bull. I had all the support in the world and everything, you know, people were pouring their hearts out to me and writing me letters, and I just didn't know what was going on. My life had just been ended to me at that point. A small part of me died on that track that day. Like, I was so depressed, like, I'm done. Like, I'm throwing the towel in. Like, this is the end of Jessy Nelson.
Motocross is my life, and I don't know what I'd do without it.
Only thing I was holding on to was Emily, to be honest. And she was there for me all the time. And she's like, it'll be okay. Like, well, nothing changes. She's like, you're just sitting. Like, it's not a big deal. And I'm saving grace and blessing in disguise. She's always been great.
I literally like tried to find anything that would make him laugh or joke around or anything just to make him a little bit happier.
I mean, I wish I could say my parents were more positive, which they were positive, but my mom was kind of like, what are you gonna do now? Like, what all this? Like, look, you just signed a new contract for the next 2 years, but what's gonna happen with that? They're just gonna be done with you? Like, what's going on? Like, I'm like, chill out. Like, I just got hurt. Like, the gnarliest thing I'll ever go through. Red Bull stepped on, and Jeremy Mallott, his cousin, had gone through this, Ricky James, and he was like, we have a neurologist through Red Bull, like Dr. Robert Bray. Let's talk to him, see what we gotta do. And he made sure I had everything I possibly needed the right way. And he kind of took charge, and I can't thank him enough. He's like, I could see recovery, like definitely, but time will tell. So that's the kind of deal. And I just kept holding on to that light at the end of the tunnel. Like, hopefully something will come from this. Every day, probably 2 or 3 times a day, I was calling my team manager, Tyler Keefe, and we grew even closer than ever. I mean, I hated the guy at one point, and I think he hated me too, but we kind of grew past that, and I was just like, dude, I can't do this. And every time he was always there for me too, and like things that I didn't want to tell Emily at the time just because I didn't want to freak her out, and it was rough. Like, I didn't even want to tell my parents. And I remember he went and picked my truck up from the airport. I forgot I went shooting like the week prior, and like I had a pistol in my truck. Like right underneath the seat in a lockbox. And he calls me, he's like, hey, you know your truck's got a handgun in the front of it, right? I'm like, oh shit, I totally forgot about that. You know what, why don't you hang on to that handgun? I was like, I mean, talking about it now, I can laugh. I was just like, I was in a dark place. I was like, fuck, I don't want that thing anywhere near me when I get home. Like, it's gonna be horrible, because I'm gonna come home, I'm gonna look around, I'm gonna see my helmets up high, I'm gonna like see all your stuff and your whole life that you've worked for, you know? Where do I go from here? And then I finally started like realizing like, there's really nowhere to go, but you know, up from here. You know, I'm not gonna go any further lower, so might as well start picking things up and piecing it together. I'm gonna do something that's gonna make me like a little bit more happy, and you know, have a good mindset, because I feel like that was the biggest deal for me. I was like, my body is only gonna allow so much, like it's only gonna do so much, it's only gonna heal so much. So, I mean, I've taken all the vitamins and done all the eating and drinking of everything I possibly could imagine and do, and I'm just like, you know what? I just want to be happy, you know. So my mom and dad were like, kind of gnarly with me at first, and finally I just like snapped. I'm like, fuck, I'm 22 years old. Like, what's gonna put me in a good mood? I'm doing it.
I was on a trip out to California. I was stopping by Troy Lee Designs to visit with those guys, and I ran into you in the downstairs, and we met up by chance. And you know, I heard about your story, and you know, very quickly Troy and Mike from Troy Lee Designs got behind it as well, and we built that razor and decided to get you back out riding again. The thing for me was, I met you and you seemed like such a genuine person, and it's sometimes you just meet somebody and you can just tell that you want to be a part of that person's life.
After the accident, we wanted to be able to let him know that we're still part of the family and he's still part of the family. It's very important to let him know that he's still one of us, and anything we can do to help him continue to live out his dream is something we're all on board for. Can we go back?
I definitely want to still be in the dirt and do all that. And everybody's been so generous to me, and I want to be able to go take people out in the same position that I'm in, getting hurt, paralyzed, or whatever. And they want to go out and still have fun. They can. You know, it's a great way to kind of just escape, I'd say, than you know, the day-to-day grind. Hopefully, get more people into it, because it's so fun and it's awesome.
Not everything's about racing. You know, there's so much more to life, and you can do so much still, and I'm still trying to with Polaris and, you know, providing me with the Razor and being able to go out and still go up in the mountains and stuff. I can't hike them. I love hiking. Sneaking into the cool fishing spots and stuff like that, that all kind of fizzled out. So now I have a way to get up there and have fun, and I'm still staying competitive, and I want to keep racing. And I didn't get to accomplish everything that I wanted to in racing. You know, it was my dream, my original dream. Now it's, how do I be the best on four wheels? How do I get myself into a trophy truck or pro light or something like that, where I look at who's racing and I'm like, I mean, yeah, I'm not walking, but what's the difference between he or she or I, you know? I wasn't done racing for me, so this is another way for me to fulfill something, and I'm not done yet, that's for sure.
Are you happy yet? How do you measure if you're over it?
I could honestly say I think he's here more than any other client that I have. Basically, what we have going on with his nervous system is a lot of positive things, a lot of good things. Just since the time from day one since he came in to now, his nervous system has really dramatically improved. Every time he comes in, we try something a little bit harder. I keep putting him on that sort of cusp of what he can and can't do. And as long as we're in that range of where he's got a little bit of fear, he's got stress on the body, the nervous system will always try to come up and meet that demand. It is a long process. The nervous system, you know, takes a while to get all these things orchestrated because it's creating, you know, movement. That's the number one job of it. I see a lot of recovery in his future because as his body gets better, his nervous system starts turning on more, it just opens up the gates to more stuff starting to work.
Tell you what's going on with his body and progress we're seeing.
It's paralyzed. No, don't try to sugarcoat her.
These things, if they don't kill you, it makes you stronger. And, you know, I got hurt 3 years ago myself pretty bad and told my wife I wouldn't race anymore. And after this happened, I was like, God, we're only on the planet for a short amount of time. We have to do what makes us happy and what we love. Took me a month or two, but after that, I finally told my wife, I want to start racing again. My son's racing. I'm not going to sit on the tailgate. We got to do what we love to do. So I kind of look at it like maybe the glass is half full here. You know what? We can't just sit around and worry about this. We got to go out there and do what we love to do. And Jesse's made the best of it.
Just getting into Vegas for the Polaris intro, the 2018 model lineup for... Destination is on your left. Yeah, we're here. I'm hoping I have something I can drive with because I'm going to need hand controls. I mean, I have portable ones for a car, but I'm not sure if they'll work, but... Maybe we can rig something up. I'm sure somebody's got some zip ties, duct tape, wire tie, I don't know, anything. We'll figure it out. Let's get this hunk of shit out of here. There we go. Woo.
From a bad dream.
For any sport, he's a role model. If it's driving, you know, Razors or getting into NASCAR or any kind of four-wheel racing, he's going to be huge for any sport and any sport that he decides to go with and pursue. They're very lucky to have him.
Catalina's always been special to me. That was one of my first professional races, actually. I went there to race for Red Bull and ended up doing one of the legendary GPs of Catalina.
Jessy Nelson, a lot of people talk about this kid making his pro debut, and what a debut it is. He's out front early on.
Ended up winning later on. You know, a few years down the road, I started dating Emily officially at Catalina. Later returned and asked her to marry me there.
You rescued me when my mind was in a prison. You set me free when no one else would listen. Now I finally feel...
He wanted to take pictures of me on his new camera. So I started, like, taking all these pictures and stuff, and he told me to come over and to look at the pictures with him, and I was, like, going through them and looking at the different pictures and laughing at half of them, and then one of the pictures was a ring, and I was like, what the heck? Like, what is this? And then I, like, looked down, and then he had it there, and then he, like, proposed to me. It was just, like, perfect.
Though the distance grows between us, girl, our love won't fall apart. I'll take care of your heart, no matter where we are. I know you feel so incomplete. The world is nothing without you, you see. If I had spent my dying breath convincing you...
How are you?
Doing all right, yourself?
Not bad.
How are you?
I'm cruising. It was 95 at our house.
Really?
The day before we left.
Yeah.
So come here, it's a pretty big adjustment.
Hey.
Holy shit, you got some.
I'm glad you didn't notice it. Well, we didn't think everybody else should have all the fun and not you.
So you set that up?
You set that up.
Thank you.
Everybody did.
Now the pressure's on, I guess, huh?
Well, then this one's going home with you.
The plane?
Yeah, we just put it.
No way.
Stuck it right next to your chair.
You're the man. Thank you so much.
So this is when we want you to race. So when you're ready to race.
I'm ready. Let's go race right now. Are you driving? Are you driving?
We have your helmet here.
It's right there.
Go ahead.
It's easy.
All right.
Immediately when we did the two-seater and you talked about wanting to go racing again, I knew this vehicle was coming, and I immediately started talking to Mike about it and saying, when you do decide to go racing, that this is the vehicle to go race in.
It's a lot like a motorcycle. It's pretty cool.
He was flying around this track. It'll be exciting to see him be able to compete again and kind of thrive in his natural environment. So we're excited to be able to do that for him, and hopefully he can get racing again soon.
That way you have the two-seater for you and Emily, and you got this bad boy to go rip around the track in.
I still can't believe I have one. Now I have two. I'm so stoked. Can't believe it. I just can't thank you and everyone at Polaris enough for everything you've done. You've gone above and beyond, and now it's my turn to produce some wins. I definitely left some things on the table with motorcycle racing, and now transitioning into this. I have a new goal now, and that's to win some shit.
Well, based upon the couple laps I saw you do out there, I think it'll be fine.
This is the mentality you need. This is for the number 13 from extended family, speaking on behalf of the motor community.
My hopes for Jessy is just to stay who he is. You know, if that's walking, if that's in a chair, it doesn't matter to me. It's the personality that he has that being in a chair doesn't define him at all.
Shit, I would like to say he's still driving a Razor next year, but actually using the foot controls, man.
It's hard to say if I would change anything. I mean, I changed that day. In a heartbeat. I mean, no questions about that. Would I change anything? You might call me dumb, but no way.
The world's a better place with Jessy.
Still smiling, man. He's rolling around in his wheelchair, and in my mind, I go, Jesse's gonna walk again. It's gonna happen. And that's the attitude Jessy has, and that's the attitude I have, so.
midnight strikes, but I can't close my eyes. These dreams of mine keep me sweating all night. It's hard to see this gift run away from me, like water down a drain. You watch it slip away.
All we ever had was fun. Like, when I think of Jessy, it's like fun.
Daylight is closing in on me. It's closing in on me. It's closing in on me. Life brings another day. Some sunlight, others rain. What will it hold for me? There's hope my cards have not been seen. You know your heart will carry you through. It's all you need. Through a crack in a well-closed blind, and so the sun reminds to all those counting time. Start over again. Watch the sun fall from the sky when the smallest